Good morning and welcome to the reading of the first epistle of Paul, the Apostle, to the Thessalonians. The first epistle of Paul, the Apostle, to the Thessalonians, chapter 1 onwards. Paul and Silvanus and Timotheus unto the church of Thessalonians, which is in God the Father and in Lord Jesus Christ. Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We give thanks to God always for you all, making mention of you in our prayers. Remembering without ceasing your work of faith and labor of love and patience of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ and the sight of our God and our Father. Knowing, brethren, beloved, your election of God, for our gospel came not unto you in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Ghost, and in much assurance, as we know what manner of men we were among you for your sake. And we became followers of us and of the Lord, having received the word in much affliction with the joy in the Holy Ghost, so that ye were ensembles to all that believe in Macedonia and Achaia. For from you sounded out the word of the Lord, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but also in every place your faith to God's word is spread abroad, so that we need not to speak anything. For they themselves show of us what manner of entering in we had unto you, and how he turned to God from idols to serve the living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, even Jesus, which delivered us from the wrath to come. Chapter 2. For yourself, brethren, know our entrance in unto you, that it was not in vain, but even after that we had suffered before, and were shamefully entreated. As ye know, at Philippi we were bold in our God to speak you the gospel of God with much contention. For our exhortation was not of deceit, nor of uncleanliness, nor of guile. But as we were allowed of God to be put in trust with the gospel, even so we speak, not as pleasing men, but God, which trieth our hearts. For neither at any time use we flattering words, as you know, nor a cloak of covetousness, God is witness, nor of men sought we glory, neither of you nor yet of others, when we might have been burdensome as the apostles of Christ. For we were gentle among you, even as a nurse cherisheth her children. So being affectionately desirous of you, we were willing to have imparted unto you not only the gospel of God only, but also our own souls, because ye were dear to us. For ye remember, brethren, our labor and travail for laboring night and day, because we would not be chargeable unto any of you. We preached unto you the gospel of God. Ye are witnesses in God also, how holily and justly and unblameably we behaved ourselves among you that day. And we know how we exhorted and comforted and charged every one of you, as a father that his children, that ye would walk worthy of God, who has called you unto his kingdom and glory. For this cause also thank we God without ceasing, because when ye received the word of God, which ye heard of us, ye received it not as the word of men, but as it is in the truth, the word of God, which effectually worketh also in you that believe. For ye, brethren, became followers of the churches of God, which in Judea are in Christ Jesus. For ye have also suffered like things of your countrymen, even as they have of the Jews, who both killed the Lord Jesus and their own prophets, and have persecuted us, and they please not God, and are contrary to all men, forbidding us to speak to the Gentiles, that they may be saved, to fill up their sins always. For the wrath is come upon them to the uttermost. But we, brethren, being taken from you for a short time in presence, not in heart, endeavored the more abundantly to see your face with great desire. Wherefore we would have come unto you, even I, Paul, once and again, but Satan hindered us. For what is our hope or joy or crown of rejoicing? Are not even ye in the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ at his coming? For ye are our glory and joy. Chapter 3. Wherefore, when we could no longer forbear, we thought it good to be left in Athens alone, and sent Timotheus, our brother and minister of God, and our fellow laborer in the gospel of Christ, to establish you and to comfort you concerning your faith, that no man should be moved by afflictions. For yourself know that we are appointed thereunto. For verily, when we were with you, we told you before that we should suffer tribulation, even as it came to pass, and we know. For this cause, when I could no longer forbear, I sent to you, know your faith, lest by some means the tempter have tempted you, and you labor be in vain. But now when Timotheus came from you unto us, and brought us good tidings of your faith and charity, and that ye have good remembrance of us always, desiring gratefully to see us, as we also to see you. Therefore, brethren, we were comforted over you in all our affliction and distress by your faith. For now we live, if we stand fast in the Lord. For what thanks can we render to God again for you, for all joy wherewith we joy for your sakes before our God, night and day, praying exceedingly that we might see your face and made perfect that which is lacking in your faith. Now God himself and our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ direct our way unto you, and the Lord make you to increase and abound in love one to another and towards all men, even as we do toward you, to the end that he might establish your heart unblameable in holiness before God, even our Father, at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ with all his saints. Chapter 4. Furthermore, then, we beseech you, brethren, and exhort you by the Lord Jesus, that as ye have received of us how we ought to walk and to please God, so ye would abound more and more. For ye know what commandments we give you by the Lord Jesus. For this is the will of God, even your sanctification, that ye should abstain from fornication, that every one of you should know how to possess his honor vessel in sanctification and honor, not in the lust of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles which know not God, that no man may go beyond and defraud his brother in any manner, because the Lord is avenger of all such, as we also have forewarned you and testified. But God has not called us unto uncleanliness, but unto holiness. He therefore that despiseth, despiseth not man, but God, who has also given us the Holy Spirit. But as touching brotherly love, ye need not write that I write unto you. For ye yourself are taught of God to love one another. And indeed ye do it toward all brethren which are in Macedonia. But we beseech you, brethren, that ye increase more and more, that ye study to be quiet and to do your own business, to work with your hands as we commanded you, that ye may walk honestly toward them that are without, and that ye may have lack of nothing. But I will not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning that which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if ye believe that Jesus died and rose again, even to them, so them also which sleep in Jesus will bring God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord, shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Chapter 5. But of the times and seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you, for yourself know perfectly the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall see peace and safety, then sudden destruction shall come unto them, as travail upon a woman with child. They shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not in darkness, that the day shall overtake you as a thief. Ye are all children of light, and the children of the day. We are not of the light, nor of darkness. Therefore let us not sleep, as do others, but let us watch and be sober. For they that sleep, sleep during the night, and they that be drunken are drunken in the night. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet and the hope of salvation. For God has not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake and sleep, we should live together with him. Wherefore, comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also ye do. And we beseech you, brethren, to know them which labor among you and are over you in the Lord, and admonish you, and to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake, and be at peace among yourselves. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient toward all men. See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Quench not the spirit, despise not prophecies, prove all things, hold fast that which is good, abstain from all appearance of evil, and the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. And I pray God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Faithful is he that called you, who also will do it. Brethren, pray for us. Greet all the brethren with a holy kiss. I charge you by the Lord that this epistle be read unto all the holy brethren. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen.